I am Santosh Gayankar. Today's concept is about the thick cylinder. These are the direct formulas I am going to use for solving the thick cylinder. Now this is the question. This is the question. A thick cylinder pipe of outer diameter D naught 300 mm and internal diameter 200 mm is subject to an internal fluid pressure of Pi 20 Newton per mm square and external P naught 5 Newton per mm square. We have to determine the maximum hoop stress develop and draw the variation in the and 25 every interval of 25 mm thick. No problem. This is the formulas, list of the formula. Here Pi and P naught is given, therefore you have to use this formula. If P naught is not given, then you have to use this formula. That means P naught, if you substitute 0, you will obtain this formula. The notations are written here. Okay, the only difference between the tangential and radial is positive sign and negative sign. I will write directly in order to make the video in order for making the video smaller. Theta sigma r is nothing but, I will write this formula directly, Pi Di square minus P naught D naught square divided by D naught square minus Di square, plus or minus, minus for radial, plus for tangential, Di square D naught square Pi minus P naught square divided by 4 R square D naught square minus Di square. Now substitute the values here. I am going to substitute the value. Pi is 20, 200 square minus 5 into 300 square divided by 300 square 200 square plus or minus 200 square into 300 square. Pi is 20 minus 5 divided by 4 R square 300 square minus 200 square. If you simplify, you will obtain the value 7 plus or minus 1.08 into 10 raised to 6 divided by 4 R square. Now I will consider the table here. Table, this is radius mm, tangential or hoop stress sigma theta Newton per mm square. This is a radial stress sigma r Newton per mm square. First you have to consider ri value, next rm, r naught, inner radius, mean radius and outer radius. For ri, Di divided by 2, you have to do it. What is Di? 200 divided by 2 is nothing but 100 mm. For outer, D naught divided by 2, 300 divided by 2 is nothing but 150 mm. Now 100 plus 150 divided by 2, you will get 125 mm. That means 25 mm interval. 100, 25, again 25. In the 25 interval. That is the meaning of this part. Now we have to substitute the theta value. How to get theta? 7 plus 1.08 into 10 raised to 6 divided by 4 into, what is Ri value? 100. You will obtain, Ri square it is. 34. This is the 34 value. 34. Next, I will go for 125. 125. 24. 24.28. Next, I will go for R naught value. 150, 19. Next, I will go for radial stress. Only minus sign here to substitute in this equation. This is the minus. I will start from the bottom. This is the minus 5. Minus 5. Now, next will be 125. 10.28 and next is 100. Minus 20. Now draw the diagram. After getting this value, draw the diagram. First, I will go for tangential stress sigma theta. In this way it obtained, but there is a value at the end, sigma r 100 mm, sigma m 125 mm, sigma naught 150 mm. Values will be 34 newton per mm square, and this value at the middle 24.28 newton per mm square, and the last 19 newton per mm square. This is we call as a hoop stress. These are the arrows. You have to show the stress distribution here. In the first video I didn't show it. In the second video I am showing it here. Now second, exactly here, this RI value will be remain same here, 100 mm. RM will be 125. This means R in terms of mm. R naught 150 mm. R mm. The graph obtained will be in this way. It doesn't coincide here because there is a value minus 5. Minus 10.28. Minus 20. This is sigma R newton per mm square. Newton per mm square. This is the stress distribution. If you measure the difference here from this part to this part, 19 minus 5, it will be 14 newton per mm square. Sometime in book it is called as a value. If you measure the difference here, it is also 24.28 minus 10.28, it will be 14 newton per mm square. Similarly, this part, if you measure, it will be 14. 34 minus 20, it will be 14 newton per mm square. And this value we call as a value. And this diagram we call as a radial stress. In this way, you can solve the problem directly by using these formulas. I am Santosh Gaidankar. Thank you very much.